Hello and welcome back, friends. Today's project is on pothos plant or money plant. I'm doing the project on pothos plant because it is the most easiest plant to take care, which fits our busy schedule and has really nice shiny leaves that not only add beauty to your house or workplace but also give fresh air, which can help relieve stress. So today I'm going to show you how to multiply pothos plant at home with a very simple trick and get maximum number of plants. I will also share my lesson learned from different pothos projects and aware you on them. Don't go anywhere, let's begin. So to start with the pothos project, you should take a fresh and healthy branch of the pothos plant, which every of the leaf on this branch, it is equally viable to grow into a whole new plant. You can see the root, the stem that will appear from that node, and the healthy leaf. So this leaf is very important to grow this small portion of the branch into a whole new plant. So always take a fresh and healthy branch. The number of leaves you can see on this stem is equal to the number of new plants. So that's why it is very important to take a very healthy and fresh plant. So now cutting the branch just below the node region so that the branch will have a root and a small stem and a fresh leaf. So this will act as a complete new plant. And this green portion is of no use since it doesn't have any potential to grow. So we'll just throw it out and cutting the another leaf with a similar way. In the same way, we will cut the whole branch so that each of the leaf will have a root, a small stem, and a complete leaf on them. Now collect all the cuttings. I'm going to use a wire just to bundle them up. It's optional, you can do it or you just want to leave it like that. And I'm using a glass pot here and using a clean water. You can use a plastic bottle also just to do this process. And now dipping all of the cuttings inside the water and leaving like that, and place this thing in indirect sunlight area or the bright light area, and they will grow slowly. Checking after 2 weeks, now we're gonna see how the growth has occurred. You see the leaves are still very healthy, the water is also very clean. I haven't changed in 2 weeks, and you can see the fresh white roots that had appeared from the base. Now let's check deep into that. You can see all the white roots, they are the new growth. They just appeared from the node region. And you can see the brown roots, they are the old roots. And even the brown roots has appeared the new white roots. Almost all of the branches has got the new set of roots. So when the roots turn 1 to 2 inches long, now it's time to transplant them into the separate pot. Here I'm using the potting mix to grow these cuttings into this pot. You can use the normal garden soil mixed with compost as well, it's completely fine. Putting all of these branches into this potting soil, make sure that the root faces downward whereas the stem faces upward, and make sure they are deep inside the soil completely. There is no problem with that one. Similarly, put all the stems in the same fashion inside this potting mix. Try to put all of these leaves upright so that you know they can get equal amount of light and they can grow in a healthy way. Water them thoroughly until the time you can see some water is draining out from the base like this. Once everything is all set, put this pot back into the window where it can get nice and bright indirect light so that the plant will have nice and steady growth without any stress. Checking after 4 weeks, the plant has brought into my plant room. It gets nice and bright indirect sunlight over here. New growth has appeared from the top of this small stem. So this is going well. And at the base, the nice white roots has come out from the base. The plant is growing in a very healthy way. So I'll just leave it like this over here for some time and check the next update. Now checking after 6 weeks, you can see some few yellow leaves in that pot, that's completely fine, but most of the leaves are still green. I don't like those yellow leaves, so I'm just trying to take them off. These leaves has already done their job, I mean, they have already collected enough food for the new plant, and the new plant has already grown up. All the small leaves that has appeared, they are the new growth. All of these new leaves, they are more 6-7 new leaves over here, they are the new growth. That means the small portion of cutting that we planted has grown into a whole new plant. And now checking the roots, you can see the roots are nice and healthy. They even have gone out from the base of the pot, and you can see some of the water is still left on that small saucer. So just make sure that you water them thoroughly, give plenty amount of indirect light, and the plant will definitely grow. If you became successful with this project, within a year you will have a hanging basket like this, and within a couple of years your pothos plant will look amazing and so beautiful like this. And I just want to tell you that don't be afraid of cutting the pothos branch to multiply them, because they will find ways to grow even longer, taller, just from sideways. So feel free to cut and multiply your pothos plant. Always make sure that you remove the yellow, dead and dried leaves out of the pothos plant, just to make sure your pothos basket is safe, out of disease and healthy. The other time I started growing the pothos plant, and one day I left my pothos pot outside, and overnight, because of the frost, all of the leaves were completely dead, even the stem was dead. So just wanna aware you that don't place your pothos plant in the frost area, they will die eventually. And also wanna share with you that even the leaves or even the stem is dead, even the small portion of the stem is alive, just keep it like that. It will grow slowly, gradually, but one day you will have a good pothos plant even out of that stem. So you can leave it like that. So this is all about the pothos project. I hope you get some idea on how to grow pothos plant. If you have any questions, concerns, please feel free to comment below. I'll be more than happy to answer you. And if you like my video, please do share it, give it a thumbs up, and please don't forget to subscribe for more interesting videos. Thank you, and see you again.